topographic maps in minutes. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. If it wasn't obvious, this video is all about topographic maps, but more than anything, I'm going to show you how to make this in just about under 2 minutes. So for this example, I'm going to be doing a topographic map of Ben McDooey. So Ben McDooey is the second tallest Munro here in Scotland, and basically I'm just finding it on Google Maps first to just get myself acquainted with the surrounding area. Now the key here is this website here, contours.axismaps.com. Once you're in there, all you have to do is put in your location. So Ben McDooey for me, I'm going to go to Ben McDooey in. And now this is the key part for me here. So we've got this here. So there's the Nephi Bridge. And if we go here, we can see the Nephi Bridge is there. So we'll quickly just be able to find it. I think Ben McDooey is this right here. So I'm going to just bring that up to the center of the screen. Bring Ben McDooey up to the center of the screen and just quickly go here on the top left to the edit styles. I'm going to change this to illuminated contour polygons because that really will show off the height data much better. And then we're just going to go back and forth just to confirm that that there is Ben McDooey. So yes, so I can see this valley bit here is the valley bit right here. So fantastic. So we know where Ben McDooey is now. So let's go ahead and now let's zoom in. So I can double click to zoom on in, or you can press this button here. I'm going to zoom in one more time, and every single time it's going to do drawing those contours. So I have a feeling that that's a little bit too close for what I'm wanting. So I'm going to go back one, and that there I think is going to be it. It does take a little bit of time, this, but trust me, this is the fastest way that I've found, and I've tried many, many websites here for this. So once we have that, so we know that that there is Ben McDooey. Let me just double check that one more time. No, Ben McDooey is right next door. So Ben McDooey is this hill here. So I'm going to bring that onto the center of my screen. And now with that done, let's go ahead and turn it back to just contour lines. And I'm going to change some of the digits here, some of the units. So first of all, I want this to be in meters, not feet. And instead of every 500 meters, let's go for every 100. So I put that in and look, there's a big change already. So 100, just for the sakes of making things a little bit more legible, I'm going to make this a dark blue. And then from there, here's what I find really interesting. So from my video of where I showed you how to make thick and thin lines from just doing kiss cuts, we can now change this to have an index interval value. And let's go for an interval value of 500. I think that's going to be a pretty decent one. So you see here, we've got these now thick lines every now and then. So with that done, that's really it. So now we're just going to go here to download, and we're going to download an SVG. So we're going to hit download, and that is now downloaded this view. Now, there is one thing to keep in mind. I've just downloaded this with the roadmaps. Usually I do it without. So if you don't want the roadmaps like I don't, just up here on the top left, you can turn off the roadmaps and you can re-download it that way. Now, I'm going to go and pop this into Illustrator. Oh, I just need to get this to reload. There we go. I'm going to pop this into Illustrator as I'm not that great in Inkscape, but for those of you that know Inkscape really well, this can all be done in there. So here's our download now in Illustrator. So I'm just going to quickly just copy this over into the file that I'm wanting to work with. So here we go. So we can see that it's really nice and big. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is just quickly make myself a little circle for this coaster. Now, I'm making this coaster 100 millimeters by 100, so 10 centimeter in diameter. So here's my 10 centimeter circle. I'm just going to quickly change this to some extreme color. Fantastic. And I'm also just going to bring up the thickness of this a little bit so that I can really see it. So there we have it. Now I'm going to make sure that we have this at the front. So range, bring front. And now we're going to grab this here, and we can see that every single one of these is an individual line. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the thick line first. So this thick line here, and I want to select all the ones that are the same to it. Of course, there aren't that many thick lines, so you could just select this individually. So I could say that one there, and then there's this one here. It's done in layers, so it's not each individual one, so it's not that tedious. So let's just do that one more time. Let's select that. Then we're going to select the same appearance. Then I'm grouping these, and I'm doing the same with the other ones. So select the same appearance and group those as well. Now, my dark line already has a color, and the thin line also has a color, but I'm going to just change this color so that they're not the same. So I'm going to change it to a red for the thin ones. And now I'm going to grab my file here, and I'm going to drag it down because we know where Ben McDewey is, which is right there. And that's a little large for me. So I'm going to go ahead and just scale this in. Now, of course, if you have a consistent scale that you would like to keep with, for instance, you were making a collection of coasters like this, you would have this right. Download them all so that they're all scaled consistently to one another. So I think that there is going to be quite nice. So that's a decent cutaway of it. Fantastic. So now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to select my font that I have here on the side. Just move it out the way for a little bit. And I'm going to use my direct selection tool. And I'm just going to select everything that I don't need here. So all this on the side, I'm going to delete that there. All this here on the side, right to around there, I'm deleting. All this right up to about there, I'm deleting. And all this right to about here. So there we go. We've already cleaned up the scene a whole bunch. Now, the way that maps are marked, so the peak of a map is with a little triangle. So I'm just going to go ahead and recreate this triangle here so that I have it as I want it. So go like that. And I think the way I had this was a width of 2 millimeters is the little triangle that I've just created. This usually in a map signifies the peak. Now I can see here that this triangle is going to be a little bit too big. So let's select all these lines here, making sure that we get them all, deselect our cut line here, and now let's just go ahead and scale this up to make sure that our triangle will fit nicely. We might be losing a little bit of the resolution that we'd want, but I would like to make sure that that's in there. So there we go. I think something like, actually, let's go down here, move that a little bit off to the side, somewhere there. I think that looks good to me. Now let's bring this triangle in. Let's see, is this triangle still too big? It is just about, but I don't want to make that triangle any smaller. So let's go ahead and select all these lines once again, making sure that I do select them all, because if I don't select them all, we're going to have some problems. So you know what I'll do? I'm going to select them all like this, deselect my outer line here, and deselect my triangle. And now let's scale these up just a touch more, about there. Yeah, that works. Okay, fantastic. Now with that done, let's replace this triangle in its position, and let's go ahead and put the text in. So the text here of Ben McDewey. Fantastic. And we don't need this text anymore. Now, of course, like I said, make sure that if you are keeping a consistent scale and doing a collection of these, that you scale these all the same. So then all the spacing of these lines will be the right for you. So now let's just delete what is left here and put that text back. Yeah, something like that I think will look quite nice. And now while we're at it, let's select everything here, rotate it by 45 degrees to remove these extra lines here on the side. So removing that there, removing this here, and removing that there. And let's see if there's any loose lines that won't be in the design at all. We can also delete them because they're just not needed, because quite frankly they're not going to be kiss cut. So with that there removed, fantastic. Let's go ahead and now just rotate this so that we have the quickest engraving possible. So that would be like that for me. And with that done, now let's go and bring it into our laser cutting app. So here we are within our Glowforge app. Of course, if you don't have a Glowforge, you will be using your own laser operating app. So let's go ahead and just place this where we're going to be using it. Let's make sure that we focus up while we're at it. And let's go ahead, and what we're going to do is do the thin lines first, then the thick line, then the engraving. So I'm going to go and set my thin lines to be my 3mm birch kiss cut. My thick lines, it's the same birch kiss cut, except I'm changing this to my maximum offset of 6mm. And then I'll just be changing this to my birch 3mm engraving. And then this one's going to be my birch cutting. So with that pretty much in place, let's just move this somewhere like that. Fantastic. That there is the coaster in place of Ben McDewey. Let's hit ready and laser cut this design. And it's as easy as that to use contour maps within your own creations. Of course, this is a very simple application. If you want, you can create three-dimensional maps instead of kiss cutting the lines by cutting the wood, or you can go ahead and create large wall art with it. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it means the world to me to have your support. And if you're enjoying the content that I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we now have a Discord channel. The link is down in the description as well, where I would love to see what you create with this new knowledge. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.